color is an integral part of UX design. Developers often devote a considerable amount of time to selecting color palettes that provide an enjoyable user experience. Color also can be used to convey meaning and guidance to users. This is where developers need to be careful and ensure users with disabilities can obtain the same meaning and guidance in other ways. After completing this lesson, you should be able to plan and test colors that meet accessibility standards. Recall design tips for ensuring the use of color meets these standards, and ensure your UI designs convey information using more than just color. In previous lessons, you heard the advice to identify and address accessibility requirements early in the design process. This is especially true for elements that form the core of your application, such as the contrast between text and background colors used in all the various interfaces and sites. Some vision impairments prevent users from distinguishing text from the background unless there is a sharp contrast between the colors used. This contrast can be measured using what's called a color contrast ratio. If you're used to determining color palettes based on visual appeal alone, then either of these designs may seem acceptable. However, in order to meet WCAG standards, there needs to be a minimum contrast ratio of 4:5:1 between the text and background colors, with a few exceptions. Only this example meets the requirement. As a developer, what can you do? First, consider reusing color palettes from other applications that have passed accessibility testing and use the same text and background colors. Remember, the contrast rule also applies to site navigation bars and tabs. Note that the accent color parameter is applied throughout a site. When determining the color palette of an application, ensure this has an appropriate contrast. Finally, because the eyeball test may not suffice, test the contrast of your colors using the WebAIM Contrast Checker, a free online resource. The next major takeaway is to ensure your designs convey information using more than just color. If we tell Tim, who is colorblind, to work on the failed ones listed on the screen, he won't be able to distinguish red circles from green ones. Users should not need to identify colors in order to complete a task or understand the meaning of data. You could rectify this problem by adding text or using two different icons to convey the pass-fail status. Also remember to use accessibility text. When designing any type of chart, add a QA checkpoint for yourself to verify that the different data sets can be distinguished from one another by more than just color. Remember this chart that you saw earlier, where only solid colors were used? Tim, who is colorblind, cannot distinguish one bar from another because they look the same to him. One solution is to tell Tim to set his Appian accessibility setting to show different fill patterns in bar, pie, and column charts. We'll revisit these settings in the next lesson. You can also display data labels in a chart to help users analyze the data being shown. In this pie chart, you should show tooltips so that each pie slice name and value is displayed when the user hovers the mouse over it. To recap this lesson, you learned that a specific contrast ratio between screen text and background is required for accessibility. You also learned some tips to meet this requirement and test your colors. Another requirement is to ensure information in an application is conveyed using more than just color. Icons and/or text can be used in addition to color. When designing charts, remind end users to enable accessibility settings so they can see different fill patterns. Also consider adding data labels to charts. When feasible, add grids that display the same data values represented in the charts.